Hey everyone and welcome back to my channel. Today's video I am going to be doing an updated look at how I am using my mini Happy Planner wallet. The last time this was featured on my channel was maybe like a year and a half ago, and oh my goodness, I still get a ton of questions about where I got this. So I'll try to make sure to leave a lot of the important information down in the description box below so you know where to buy it and all the information about it, just in case I miss anything on here. Or if I didn't fully answer your question, make sure to just leave me a comment and I'll make sure to respond back. So let's go ahead and just open this up. For right now, I just have it set up for just keeping it at home, I guess. And if I were to need to go out or something, it's ready for me to just put my debit card in here and ready to go. But for right now, since we are staying at home and not really doing much, just doesn't leave the house because I don't leave the house. So let me just show you guys how I have it set up. I did decide to keep the Mom Life cover, but I am testing out the Happy Planner Budget Edition, the Mini Happy Planner Budget Edition, I think that's what it's called. It's undated, but I decided to just keep this cover because I like it. So starting with, before I get into here, let me just start on this side really quick. I'm kind of getting ahead of myself here. So what I have on this side is just extra pages here, like inserts if I wanted to jot some notes down. And on the pocket here on this side, I do have a calculator. And then I have like a, I've had this since 2003, I should cross that I carry, that my cousin gave me. So that goes in there. Have a couple cards in here because I wanted to show you guys also how it's how the pockets are. And I don't think I've really fully broken this in because it's still very hard to, you know, get the card in and out. And for me, for the most part, when I'm out and about and I'm paying, I like to already have my card handy. And I find that even with this wallet, with these pockets, I would still keep my debit card like in here because I want something that I can just pull out really easily. I don't want to pull up to the register and try to fiddle with my debit card. So that's, yeah, these are kind of tricky. So these are library cards. And they're still kind of like, they're still kind of hard to take out. I find that this pocket right here was the one that kind of fit the best. So that's where my debit card was for the most part. So as I try to struggle over here, yeah, that's where my debit card really stayed. But when we are out and about, I do like the fact that it zips up so that when it's in my bag, it doesn't have, I don't even have a planner, another planner cover to show you, but I like that I can zip it up and nothing loose or nothing will come out. That's the reason why I was really on a hunt for a zippered planner wallet. A lot of the planner wallets out there are the three ring ones. I have been seeing a lot of covers, however, now that zip, that you can insert like a notebook and stuff, but they're kind of, I feel like they're kind of expensive. So I think I bought this for 30 bucks plus tax. So I don't think it was that bad when I purchased it. Again, I'll leave all that information down below, like how much it was and all of that stuff down below. So anyway, so let's go ahead and just take a look at the budget planner. I did go ahead and leave all of the months in here so you can see how full it is. I don't know if you can really tell, but these are the mini discs that come with the mini Happy Planner, of course. So yeah, it's really packed and I could really tell that it's super packed because when I try to put the papers in, it's kind of like super packed. I don't know how else to say it. So I was planning to take out maybe like 3 months so that I could put inserts in it because I do have a couple things that I still want to add. I do have on this side all of my budget categories. Still debating on what highlighters I'm going to use because I'm running out of the ones that I currently use for my budget planning in my Budget by Paycheck workbook, which is my main budget planner. And then I also have my monthly bills down here in order that it is to be paid. And then on this side, I have all of the yearly bills. And on this side here, I wanted to do an updated credit card debt payoff goal date because a lot of things has changed since I made it in January. So wanted to update that and put it in my budget planner. So anything budget related with like I wanted to put like a savings tracker in here, debt payoff tracker and stuff like that. And I'm pretty sure I'm gonna have to get rid of 3 months at least so that I can fit all that in here. So and since it is undated, I did go ahead and start off with May. It did come with the stickers, just in case you didn't see the flip through. I did do a flip through of the planner just by itself. It did come with the dates, and then I had some leftover stickers from one of the Happy Planner sticker books, and I just added that in each of the months here. With my May financial goals for the month, they are to increase my emergency funds, stay within budget with fun and events, and to retotal of money makeover. And then there's a don't forget section here, and I just went ahead and listed all of the events going on for the month. May is pretty busy for us, so there is a ton on there. What I do like about this section here that I haven't really seen in a lot of budget planners that I've been kind of researching is the unexpected spends, because we did have a few this month. I would say two. I had a medical emergency and then a doctor's appointment follow-up, so those were all unexpected. A hospital stay and stuff. So I will be using that section there. And then for the month layout, I know it looks pretty bare. I tried to decorate it a little bit with some stickers. These are one of my favorite ones, which is by Shine Sticker Studio. I just have my bills on here and events. That's pretty much it. I didn't write anything on the notes section here. And then on the next pages, so I was still trying to figure out how I was going to use this planner because I have a certain type of way that I budget. I budget every paycheck, which we get paid every other week, so bi-weekly. So I make a budget every 2 weeks. And so with this layout, it was just, I think it took me a little bit to figure it out, but this is what I went with. So this month, so it's for the month of May, obviously. And I felt like I didn't have enough space with the income because since we did pool money from our emergency fund, I wanted to make sure we had space for that. And even now, I don't know if we're going to be pulling from our emergency fund to add to our income. So I'll just have to make a line there. That's just to cover our hospital bill. And I did make a note here that leftover money from April we did carry over, so our starting balance was this amount. And then what else? And my tracking period I forgot to write on here, so it's from May 1st to May 28th. We do get paid May 1st and we did get paid on the 15th, so that's my tracking period. It's not a full month, it's not from May 1st to May 30th, it's by the two paychecks. So if you've been following my budgeting, you guys know what I'm talking about, but anyways, moving on to the bills. Oh, I forgot this box. So the totals box, this is our income so far as of the 15th. Again, I don't know if I'm going to be pulling money out from our savings fund before the new paycheck, which is on the 29th. We'll see. I don't know when my bill is going to come in, my hospital bill. But for now, our income total minus our expenses so far, we have 2,578 remaining, and that amount is a combination of money that is going to be used for our variable expenses and for our hospital bill, which I'll get to in a little bit. Sorry if it sounds confusing. I know I'm still trying to make sense of all of this for me because I'm so used to using my budget by paycheck workbook, and I'm determined to make this work. So for the bills section here, I did have everything written down in date order for the most part. I did draw a line for when this tracking period is over. So what I mean by that is from May 1st to the 12th, these bills are being covered by our May 1st paycheck, and then the rest, so down here, these are all covered by the paycheck on the 15th. So I just drew that line there just so I know the amount of bills that are getting deducted from the May 15th. So I did total up the bills down here, and it says that our remaining amount is 2,578. Which will be going to variable spending. I did write all of this down after the 15th. So after I had already closed out our May 1st to May 14th pay period budget. So here I wrote down minus $722 that was spent in variable expenses from May 1st to May 14th, which gives us a total of 1,856. And then I did budget out 765 this time around for our variable budget, and we have a leftover of $1,091 to be budgeted for, or that's still not doesn't have a purpose other than sitting in our account waiting for a hospital bill to arrive so that I can get that paid off. So I don't know if everything sounds so confusing right now, but to me it makes sense. But let me zoom you in down here really quickly. So there wasn't really room to put down variable expenses. I did not just want to leave it alone here, like, oh, our income minus expenses, we have this much remaining. I want to make sure I put that amount somewhere. So I did create a variable spending budget kind of section here. So this part right here, I know it's super tiny. I wrote with a really fine point pen, this pen right here. And it fit just fine. Luckily, I was able to write small. If you guys are more on the if you guys write bigger, I don't know how this planner would work out for you, because I already write small and I feel like it's not that much room, or it's just enough, I mean. So yeah, as I was saying, this side right here is variable spending from May 1st to May 14th, and then this side right here is our variable spending from May 15th to May 29th, and these are the budgets here. And then I'll write down the actual that we spent when the month is over. So that's how I have that set up. And then as far as this section here, I will be using this as a savings tracker. We do have an automatic transfer going on for to go into our savings account. It's just set up monthly to be taken out of our checking account and put into our savings. And then I still don't know whether or not we're going to make any extra debt payments, but this is what I'm going to use that section for. I think after I filled this out, I was like, oh shoot, I think I was supposed to maybe put my debts into here. So I just made it a section where I'll put down all the extra maybe debt payments or something in here. Oh, and I also forgot to mention that in each month there is a no spend challenge, or there's a monthly budget challenge, and this month is to try not to spend on necessities. Oh, try only to spend on necessities for at least 1 week during this month. So, yeah. So moving on to the expense tracker. This I changed up a little bit because, again, I have a certain way that I like to track my expenses or do my budgets that make sense for me, and that is how I'm going to show you. So with weekly expenses, I don't have it broken down by week, so not from like Monday to Sunday or anything like that. I do have it by paycheck. So these two pages here, I forgot to write it down. So in these two pages here, it's from our biweekly paycheck from May 1st. So from May 1st to May 14th, May 14th is when I stopped tracking expenses this period, because we did get paid again on May 15th, and that started a whole new other expense tracking period, I guess. So that's that for these two. I did white out. It did have pre-printed categories on here, like budgets. Oh, right here. Oh, so it originally had these descriptions on here. So it had groceries, eating out, shopping trip, gas, and entertainment. And I already know my budget categories. I just didn't need to use this, so I just whited it out. And for me, groceries and eating out is together in the food category. So yeah. I also eliminated, oh, let me go back on this. I eliminated one of the columns, which kind of sucks because I think I kind of wanted to use the need and want column, but I really wanted to have a column for category, like budget category, amounts, and then our balance. because I do like to have the balance section here because I do check my account every day. And when I do check my expenses, I do make sure that it matches my account. So let's say for here, I have a check mark next to 8680, and yes, that's what was in my account when I did check. That's just like how I like to do it. So yeah. And on this side, I did write it here. So it's all the expenses from May 15th to May 28th. And then we do get paid May 29th. However, that May 29th paycheck is gonna be part of June. I did also make a note down here for myself because I already saw that I'm way over my household budget. So I wrote myself a note to keep track of needed household supplies. So there's a couple things that kind of I totally forgot about. I don't know if just everything went out the window when I was at the hospital and I totally forgot we needed toilet paper. I thought we could hold off a little bit longer, but when my husband looked inside of our closet, we were like, nope, we need some. And then we also needed ink, and ink is not cheap. And I need the ink for my son's school stuff. So yeah. That's that. And this section here, I'm gonna turn into a month review and an updated debt balance. And then it starts again in June. What I do love about this and what I miss about using a happy planner or mini happy planner is all the quotes. And I think most of the month has quotes on them. So I do miss that part. And let me just skip over to the back so you guys can see what it looks like. I was using this wallet when we were trying out cash envelopes. We did use this to hold some of our cash envelopes. I also was using it as a savings tracker also for our Hawaii fund. We were pulling out cash, but then we ended up using it. And then my husband stopped using cash. He uses debit card now, but he was using cash at work. And then but yeah, so these cash envelopes are from the Budget Mom. It was part of her freebies and one of her newsletters that you get on Friday. So it was free. So that's where I got it. In this back pocket here, I did have a notebook. I don't know where it went, but it was a nice, perfect size that fit right in here. And that actually I remember using to distract my 2-year-old. He's 3 now, but when he was 2, I used it to distract him in the car. So I don't know what you guys might want to put in there. You can put whatever you want in there, notepad or whatever in there. And pen loop, of course, right here. And yeah, that is pretty much it for this wallet setup. Again, I don't see this leaving the house anytime soon because I'm not going anywhere, but this is how it's set up for now. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you guys have any questions, make sure to leave it in the comment section down below, and I will talk to you in the next video. Have a great day, guys. Bye.